Border Collie needs its brain to be kept busy. So if you don't stimulate that, the mental side of a Border Collie, they start finding their own things. And that is when they start pulling creepy crawlies out of swimming pools, because the creepy moves, and of course a Border Collie has to move sheep. And if the creepy crawly doesn't listen, then we're going to haul it out and we're going to go and start playing with it. Same in a garden. They are fantastic horticulturalists because they need to entertain themselves. So they hear something under the grass, they go and look for it. They see something in a tree, they're going to start running around the tree to try and catch whatever's in the tree. And this is when people then discover that if you cannot keep that brain busy, you get a very difficult dog, a dog that's going to start destroying their garden, going to start destroying their pool. And that is when people decide they actually don't have the time and the energy for this breed. And if nobody picks up a toy for her when she brings it back, she'll drop it and then she'll go back and she'll wait for it to be picked up or moved or...
But she dropped it now.
This is not bringing it close to Agnes.
She's not going to lie down now, is she?
No. This is going to have to go.
So that's all the herding we're watching there, you know.
Yes.
Eh?
Yeah, so that's her watching her flock.
Yeah.
Expecting something to move, something to happen.
In her stance there, she's ready to go in any direction, so she's ready to go left or right, regardless of where her toy goes.
If you consider the Border Collie going back hundreds of years, they worked with their farmers, they were out in the field, they did their daily job, and then when the farmer went to the pub in the evening, the dog came with and lay under their chair. Mine's lying right at my feet right now, but she's equally happy out there playing. So they not only need that physical stimulation, they need the mental stimulation, they need to be with their people. They are not a good breed to be left in a garden on their own and with a family inside the house. They want to be inside the house, because remember, they are bred to look after their flocks. And as a human being, you become their flock. So if you take your Border Collie and you look at it when it works sheep, it runs kilometers and kilometers and kilometers. When they run and they lie down, it is an energy conserving thing. So a lot of your dogs will run after their sheep and they'll lie down and crouch, and then they wait for the sheep to move. They give the sheep the eye at that time, so they hold the sheep in a particular pattern.
That's quite a nice example of the eye.
She's
trying to move her toy with that look.
And then the dog will move off and bring them around to wherever they have to be. So if you consider the exercise that a Border Collie would get if it's out in the field, it is unbelievable. It is phenomenal. So yes, they do enjoy their exercise. They're great as running companions. But throwing a ball, treadmill work is fantastic. All my dogs are trained to run on a treadmill so that you can get that side of the exercise going. But as you say, bear in mind, the fitter your dog gets, the more it needs. So yes, you start them slowly running kilometers. They can do up to 10 to 15 kilometers with you just simply road running, but the fitter your dog gets, the more it needs.
So if you watch her movement there, her body, her shape is actually not changing, simply her legs are moving. So she's not going to frighten her sheep when she's working with it. So she's not storming down on them, she's literally sneaking up on them.
Okay.
So only her legs are moving, her top line doesn't change, her form doesn't change.
Okay, so if the form changes, does that scare the sheep and other animals?
Yeah.
They run hand in hand, your stimulation and your exercise. So I would not put a Border Collie into a townhouse property. You could, but then you need to be dedicated. Then you need to know that 2 to 3 times a day you're going to take that dog out and you're going to run it in the park, or you're going to take it for a run yourself. They are better off in a sort of standard earth. 1,000 square meters is great. And even so, they still need to be able to see out. They still need to be aware of what's going on around them. And you still need to do mental stimulation. Again, if you think about what they were bred for back in the day, they need to be able to see that distance. They need to be able to look and see what's happening around them. If they can't do that, they get frustrated, they get upset, they get uptight, they get depressed, because they can hear stuff going on, but they can't do anything about it. You've got, with a Border Collie, you've got brains, and you've got that sense of smell and that sound. So if you were to take the olfactory sensors of a Border Collie and actually open that membrane up, you would cover a rugby field. That is the size of it. So they are very heightened in that regard. Their ears are incredibly sensitive. Often they will hear things way before we hear them, and that is why they become weather phobic, so they become scared of thunder and lightning, because it is so much more pronounced for them than what it is for us. And again, that's something else to take into consideration when you get a Border Collie.